Good morning, dear students. So in the last lecture, we have seen about the indeterminate form, and also we have seen the basic. I've explained you that what all questions we will be going to see and which rule we have seen. Okay, that is L'Hospital rule we have seen in the last lecture. When to use L'Hospital rule, that is also I stated there, that when you have a indeterminate form, that is either 0 by 0 form or infinite upon infinite form, or 0 to the power infinite, or 1 to the power infinite, or 0 to the power 0, then there we have to use L'Hospital rule. Okay, so we already discussed about the 0 by 0 form. Now we are going to discuss about infinite upon infinite form. Okay, and we will be going to see the questions related to the same. Okay, let us come to this question. Given limit x tends to 0, log 10 2x to the base 10x. Okay, so first of all, see, this is of type infinite upon infinite form. How we can use the property of log a to the base b log a upon log b, that is 10 log of 10 2x upon log 10x. Alright, so this is infinite upon infinite form. If you put x tends to 0 in the limit, you will get infinite upon infinite form. And so we have to use L'Hospital rule in it. Okay, so using the L'Hospital rule, what will be the differentiation of log 10 to x, 1 upon 10 to x? 10 to x differentiation will be sec square 2x, and 2x differentiation is 2. Log 10x, 1 upon 10x into sec square x. Now, how I am writing? See, 1 upon tan 2x will be cot 2x, and cot 2x is what? Cos 2x upon sin 2x multiply. Sec square 2x will go into the denominator, so it will be 1 upon cos square 2x into 2, whole divided by, here also same, 1 upon tan is cot x, and cot x can be written as cos x upon sin x into this also 1 upon cos square x. Now this cos 2x to this cos 2x can be cancelled, and here in the denominator 1 cos x with cos x can be cancelled. I've taken this 2 here outside, and we are left with sin 2x cos 2x upon sin x cos x. Now what you can do after here, see, this sin 2x can be written as 2 sin theta cos theta. 2 sin 2x can be written as 2 sin x cos x. Okay, so how can you do after this one? So 2 limit x tends to 0, 1 upon 2 sin x cos x cos 2x, whole divided by 1 upon sin x cos x. So this sin x cos x to sin x cos x will be cancelled. Also this 2 with this 2 you can cancel easily. You are left with limit x tends to 0, 1 upon cos 2x, and when you put cos x tends to 0 here, cos 0 is 1, so your final answer is 1. So like this you have to do. So as we did in the previous exercise, we differentiated the numerator and denominator, and then we keep on checking it whether it is 0 by 0 form or not. So here we have to check infinite upon infinite form. Till you not get the infinite upon infinite form, you have to differentiate. You have to use L'Hospital rule here. Okay, okay, let us come to this question, algebraic question. So here in the question, what they are trying to say, limit x tends to 1, 1 upon x square minus 1 minus 2 upon x to the power 4 minus 1. If you put x tends to 1, so it will be 0, 1 upon 0 infinite, and here also it will be 0, 2 upon 0 is also infinite. So one infinite minus infinite, this is infinite minus infinite form. Okay, you cannot say that the answer will be 0 if we subtract infinite from infinite, because this infinite can be anything and this infinite can be anything. They both are they both can be countable infinite also and uncountable infinite also. Okay, so what we have to do in this question, let us take we have to use L'Hospital rule in it. Okay, so as we cannot directly apply the L'Hospital rule, first we need to simplify it. So what we are doing, we are taking the LCM, this multiplied by here, this multiplied by here, and these two in the down, we got this, and here minus 1 plus 2 will give you plus 1, and rest as it is. And this x to the power 4 minus 1 can be written as x square plus 1, x square minus 1, a plus b, a minus b, this will give you a square minus b square. Okay, Here, this is an identity of x square minus 1 the whole square. How? This is x to the power 4, x square whole square minus 2 into 1 into x square plus 1 square. So that is x square minus 1 the whole square. And this x square minus 1 and x square minus 1, this will be the whole square. And this 2 you can easily cancel. You are left with 1 upon x square plus 1. And on putting, applying the proper limits, we'll get 1 by 2 as the final answer. Okay. Okay, let us come to this question. It says, limit extends to 2, 1 upon log x minus 1, minus 1 upon x minus 2. Again, this will give you infinite upon infinite form, infinite minus infinite form. First of all, let us simplify it. What we are doing, we are taking LCM x minus 2 minus log x upon x minus 2 log x minus 1. Now, differentiate with respect to x. So this is what 1, the 2 will be 0, and minus of log x upon 1 x minus 1 will be 1 upon x minus 1 whole divided by, use product rule in these two functions. So keep x minus 2 as it is, log will be 1 upon x minus 1 plus log x minus 1, and this x minus 2 will be 1 minus 0. So I have not written, that is understood. Now again, if you put 2 at this step, you'll get 0 by 0 form. Again, we need to use L'Hospital rule. You take LCM, this multiplied by here, minus 1, a whole divided by x minus 1. And here, x minus 2 is already multiplied by 1 upon x minus, just take LCM, so x minus 1 will be multiplied here. So this x minus 1 to this x minus 1, you can cancel easily. So x minus 2 upon x minus 2 plus x minus 1 upon log x minus 1. Now here, at this step also, you will get the same 0 by 0 form. Again, you need to use the L'Hospital rule. So if you use the L'Hospital rule here, so what you will get, do one thing. Just find the answer of this one, okay? You need to find the answer and let me know what is the answer, okay? Okay, now let us come to this question. It says that limit extends to 0, cot x minus 1 upon x. Okay, so what we have done, this is infinite minus infinite form. Cot x can be written as 1 upon tan x minus 1. I've taken LCM here, okay? And I have converted this 10, now I have differentiated it, okay? So it will be what? X differentiation is 1, okay? Minus 10 will be sec square x upon, in the denominator I have used the product rule. Keeping x as it is, 10x will be sec square x plus 10x as it is, differentiation of x is 1. Now sec x can be written as 1 upon cos square x, and this sec x also upon cos square x plus 10x can be written as sin x upon cos x. Take an LCM here, so this will be cos square x minus 1 whole upon cos square x, and here also when you'll take LCM you'll get cos square x, okay? Because this is cos square x, to make this as cos square we need to multiply cos here and here, okay? So that will be whole cos square, and that cos square and this cos square can be cancelled. So cos square x minus 1 upon x plus sin x cos x. Now after this, again we are getting 0 by 0 form on putting the limit. So what, again let us differentiate. So before that, see this sin x and cos x, I am writing it as sin 2x upon 2. Can we write like this? Yes. Why? Because if 2 sin x cos x is sin 2x, if you take 2 in the down, so sin x cos x value sin 2x upon 2, okay? So cos square is 2 cos x, and cos x is minus sin x, so minus I have taken here. Whole upon x is what, 1 plus sin 2x will be cos 2x upon 2 and into 2. So this 2 is cancelled. So we are left with only this quantity. Now when you put x tends to 0, let us put, so in the upside we will get 0, but in the down what you are getting, 1 plus 1 2. 0 upon 2 is not an indeterminate form. 0 upon 2 will give you answer as 0, so 0 is the answer. Like this you have to do, okay? Okay, let us do this question. This question says that limit x tends to 0, x log 10x, okay? We have to evaluate the limit. Now here what I have done, see this x I have written in the down, and it can be written as x to the power minus 1. Now this is indefinite form or indeterminate form, so we'll use L'Hospital in the numerator log 10x will be 1 upon 10x, okay, and sec square x upon, this will be what, minus 1 x to the power minus 1 minus 1 will be minus of 2, so minus of x to the power minus 2. This 10x, 1 upon 10x can be written as cos x upon sin x, and sec square x can be written as 1 upon cos square x. Cos x to cos x will be cancelled whole upon minus, we can take out, and x square x to the power minus 2 is written in the denominator. Okay, so this how? So sin x and cos x, I already told you this is sin 2x upon 2. So this sin 2x and that upon 2 will go, it will come in the numerator, whole upon x to the power minus 2. Now this x to the power minus 2 will go with this 2 to become 2x square, and that 2x square I am writing it as 2x into x, and that 2x upon sin 2x I am writing. Why? Because we have one identity that if you limit theta tends to 0, sin theta upon theta is equal to 1, or it can be understand like if limit theta tends to 0, theta upon sin theta is also 1. Okay, that is inverse also exists, and it's normal also, the answer is 1. So this, so for that we need 2x tends to 0. Okay, so for this one your answer will be what, 1, but for x, if your x tends to 0 then 0, so 1 into 0 will be your final answer, will be 0. That is how we solve. Okay, now we are heading to the next topic, that is indeterminate form of form 0 to the power 0, infinite to the power 0, and 1 to the power infinite. Now how to deal with these questions? You know, if you understand what is the that means step by step way of solving these questions, you can understand this exercise very easy. And as I see that this is a very short exercise of having just 6 questions and 2 subparts, that is 12 questions, and examples are 6, 12 plus 6, 18, 18 questions, you can easily do it without any problem. So let me clear you how to solve this, how to deal with such questions. So you will always have the question in such a way to evaluate limit x tends to c fx to the power gx, because if the indeterminate form is of this kind, then our function will be fx to the power gx, limit x tends to some c fx to the power gx. Now what is the first step of solving this? Let fx is equal to this whole, you always consider fx is equal to this. So what we need fx as the final answer. Okay, now what I have done, let us take log both the sides, so log here also and log, when you will take log here, this gx will come out and log of fx, this you can understand easily. Now I've considered, say for example, on solving this limit you got L as an answer. Okay, on solving this you got L as an answer. Let us consider this thing. So log fx is equal to L. Now I want only fx, so this log should be removed. So we can use anti-log, but you have not studied about the anti-logs. So what we do, we use the exponential function. We take exponent both the sides. So taking exponents both the sides, e to the power log fx is equal to e to the power L. Now I told you e to the power log x will be x. So e to the power log fx is fx is equal to e to the power L. So what you need to follow, the first step is take log both the sides. Okay, solve it. Whatever you answer you get, write that answer on the power of e. So that will be your final answer. Understood? So let us take one example and understand this more better. Okay, let us come to this first question. It says limit x tends to a, x minus a to the power x minus a. Okay, so first of all, what I told you, that you always consider this function as fx. So fx is equal to limit x tends to a, x minus a to the power x minus a, taking log both the sides. Let us take log both the sides, log. So when we will take log here, this x minus a, the power will come down, and log x minus a. Now what I'm doing, I'm taking this x minus a in the down, so x minus a to the power minus 1. Okay, this will be same. What is now, this is now, here we can use L'Hospital rule. So log x minus a will be 1 upon x minus a whole divided by x to the power minus 1, you know how to differentiate. So that is minus 1 upon x minus a the whole square. Differentiation of this is this. So x minus a to 1, x minus a will be cancelled. We are left with 1 upon 1 minus 1 upon x minus. This my x minus a will come up here like this. And on putting the limit x tends to a minus a will give you 0. You got 0 as an answer. Now what I told you in that procedure, that you put this answer on the power of e to remove this log. So our fx will be e to the power 0 and e to the power 0 is 1. Like this you have to solve. Okay? Okay? Okay, now let us come to this question. It says limit x tends to pi by 2 in negative 10x to the power sine 2x. Again, let us consider fx is equal to this function. Now taking log both the sides, the sine 2x will be down log 10x. Now I am taking the sine 2x in the denominator, it will be cosec 2x. Now using the L'Hospital rule in the next step, log 10x will be 1 upon 10x and 10x is sec square x. And cosec 2x will be minus cosec 2x cot 2x. Now after this, what I want from you, you need to solve it. How can you solve? See, this tan x will be cos x upon sin x and this will be cos square x. That cos to cos will be cancelled. And you try to change this one also. This is a trigonometric part that you can solve easily. And at last when you will put pi by 2 minus of pi by 2, you will get 0 as an answer. Okay? So I want you to solve it. And finally e to the power 0 will be 1. So this was the answer. So answer I have told you, you have to now just do all the processing. Okay. Let us come to this question. It says limit x tends to infinity 1 plus x to the power 1 upon x. Consider fx is equal to this. Take log both the sides. When you will take log, 1 upon x will be down log x. Okay. Now again you just differentiate. Log 1 plus x will be 1 upon 1 plus x. And this x. See this. This is actually like this. Okay. So x differentiation is 1. So finally 1 upon 1 plus x put x tends to infinity. 1 plus infinity will be what? Infinity only. 1 upon infinity is 0. Hence log fx is 0 or fx is e to the power 0. That is equal to 1. Okay. Okay. Let us come to this question. It says limit x tends to pi by 4. 10x to the power 10 2x. Consider this fx is consider this function as fx. Taking log both the sides, log fx is equal to log. So this 10 2x will be down log of 10x. Now this 10x can be written as in the down, that is cot 2x. So log 10x upon cot 2x. Now differentiate the numerator. Log 10x will be 1 upon 10x. 10x differentiation of 10x is sec square x whole upon cot 2x. This is what? Cot 2x differentiation is minus of cosec square 2x into 2. Now after this, how to do? Just see, I'm rubbing here. This was the condition. Limit x tends to pi by 4. See, this cos square, this tan x, 1 upon tan x is what? Cot x. So, cot x can be written as cos x upon sin x into sec square is what? 1 upon cos square x. Cos x square can be written as, see this minus of 2 I am taking out. So, minus of half. Okay. And this cos x square x can be written as 1 upon sin 2 x the whole square. 1 cos to 1 cos can be cancelled. Minus of half limit x tends to pi by 4. This is 1 upon sin x cos x whole divided by one upon sin square 2x. Understanding? Now what I'm doing, see, sin x cos x is what? Sin 2x upon 2. Okay. So, in place of sin x cos x, I am writing sin 2x, that upon 2 will go up. So, here it will be 2. Understood? This 2 to this 2 we can cancel. And 1 sin 2x to 1 sin 2x we can cancel. Now, take this sin 2x up. So, it will be minus of limit x tends to pi by 4 sin 2x. x. Now put limit here. What we will get? Minus of pi by 4. 2 into pi by 4 will be pi by 2, and sine pi by 2 is 1. So minus of 1 we got. Now at last, what we need to do? Fx is equal to e to the power minus 1, or 1 upon e. Like this you have to solve. So that's it for this chapter. So here we have ended this chapter finally. So what I need from you, you know it very well, as I always tell you, to do more and more practice for the questions. Okay, so please do this. Okay, thank you.